If you like the video, make a drink and subscribe to the channel.
John Byline saw the ball leave Charles Matthews' hands. He heard the buzzer shortly after. And then the ball dropped through the net, giving no. 5 Michigan basketball a last second, 59-57 win over Minnesota. The Wolverines rebounded from their first loss of the season in dramatic fashion. Nothing went as planned, including the final offensive possession that led to the win. Column: Michigan nearly lost its second straight game. Here's why not to worry. But the only thing that mattered was Matthews' buzzer-beating jumper from along the baseline. I knew it was good, Matthews said. I always have some fear in my head 'cause Purdue last year. You never know, but I remember the game clock was 24.7 and the shot clock was 24 seconds at the time. When I saw it was 1 second, I knew for a fact that I had the time. You just do simple math. Here's how you M1, despite the blown lead, along with everything that goes into a buzzer-beating shot. Offense falters late. In the 64-54 loss at Wisconsin on Saturday, Michigan's offense was cold most of the game, and especially during the last 6 minutes. The Wolverines dealt with similar problems Tuesday night. Michigan struggled to shoot in the first half. Then the offense got worse during the final minutes yet again. After a short jumper from John Tesk gave UM a 10-point lead with 457 remaining, the Wolverines missed their next 5 field goal attempts and 2 free throws. Minnesota inched closer by attacking the paint. We just weren't hitting shots, Tesk said. We were getting some good looks, maybe forcing it a little bit, but we have to execute better down the stretch. With Michigan up 3 and under a minute left, Ignas Brazdeikis had a chance to ice the game. But his driving layup rolled out. That set the stage for the final 40 seconds. The Gophers began their final possession with a ball screen for DePree McBrayer near the top of the arcade. Michigan responded with a soft hedge against McBrayer with Xavier Simpson and Brazdeikis. Gabe Kalscher, who started the play in the corner, ran up as if he was going to set another screen for McBrayer. Then he darted outside the arcade. Simpson switched over to Kalscher, but McBrayer swung the ball over to Kalscher, who rose up and buried a 3-pointer to tie the game at 57. Chrysler Center was quiet, with only Minnesota's bench and guest section celebrating. UM inbounded the ball, and Simpson dribbled past half court before Byline motioned for a timeout.